Four wide receivers. Jesse Powell looking into the flat, tries to hit Garrett Swanson. And in his face and tipping the ball away is big number 75, Julian Stewart. And once again, this time it's Nick Champlin jumping up and getting a piece of that football and knocking it down. And he'll bring Pryor in motion left to right, takes him on the bubble screen. That ball is rolled, a fumble going all the way back to the 5-yard line. Pryor scoops it up under duress, and it'll be a loss of 17 yards.
Fires, has him out the flat. The tight end is going to be rocked and Cheney on the drive. Second down, 7 yards to go. They pitch to Rasmussen coming left, and he tripped up in the backfield in a nice open field tackle back there by the Lewiston Clark Tigers. Brad Poston,
a great play right there by Poston as the fullback actually got into him, started to block him. Poston did a good job.
It looks like Cheney going to go for it on fourth down, and it's picked off on the far sideline by Lewiston Clark Tigers. Brad Poston.
That was just a sweet catch right there by Poston. He just put one hand up, was able to, I thought he was just going to bat the ball down, but he somehow cradled it in with one hand and made the interception. Didn't show any response afterwards. You got to love that. Just a guy out there working hard, doing his job.
Yep.
There you go. Good job, man.
To the right side, pitch back to Sim. He is going to be hit back at the 30 and dropped for a big loss. Sim is going to lose 4 yards on the carry, and that'll bring up a punting situation here. 3 wide receivers to his right side, third down and 5 high snap, and he is going to be absolutely pile driven to the ground. Evan Lundberg coming on the outside. Blake Todd never saw him coming from the blind side, and he broke out the wax stick right there and put him down. Back in the shotgun, will tip it, drop back to the 35. Defender in the face, tries to throw it up. Corner and intercepted by the Walker. He'll take it at the 20, and then he'll be dropped down immediately. But that ball caused by the pressure in the backfield of
Chad Armstead.
Armstead making a hit on the quarterback.
This is a much different Lewiston Clark team. No hitch in the mouth defensively, but they're a well-balanced offense. It's a machine as well.
Second and 15, Kavanaugh. Street drop trying to set up the middle screen. This ball is intercepted. What a hit. Hit number 58 is intercepted, and then he has to go to the window. An oncoming receiver.
Slicing through for the defense for Lewiston Clark, number 25, getting his swerve on Josh Quanta.
Looking for the bullpup. Hang on to the rock, but that should be a pretty good game.
Speaking of not hanging on to the rock, dropping the soap to Tim Kavanaugh. Jump for the football. Who's going to come up with it?
It's going to be Mount Spokane after all that. I believe all 22 players on the field had a shot at that football.
The flag will drop back. Plays it into the middle. Straight drop that he takes the hand off the cable, rolling to his left, tries to pull it across the middle, it's intercepted. Intercepted in the end zone, and it's an automatic touchback just coming out of the end zone as Evan Lundberg will roll right, fires out of the flat, pushed out of bounds, well shy of the first down.
Tiger 28-yard line. A dash mark, they'll play act, and going to be caught and thrown down. The first time the LC defense is really completely blown up. A Shadle Park play
Yeah, great defensive call right there. It's a late blitz on the outside for Brad Post in the outside linebacker. He waited, made sure Powell went with the fake. When he rolled out, he was right there to bring him down. Great play by Evan Lundberg, the outside linebacker, knifing through. Had a defender in his face, the fullback trying to pick him up. He just jet the block and continued to the outside. Brought Powell down for a huge loss.
Play action. Rolling to his right, Powell trying to run around the corner. He's going to get the first down. As he does get around the corner, just as he gets around the corner, he just gets hammered out of bounds. Fourth down and inches. Offset in the backfield, behind the quarterback, Powell. Quick pitch, right side, trying to get around the corner. He'll be caught for a loss. The ball will go over on down. They gave it to Kiter, trying to get around the corner, and they strung it out, and the LC Tigers dropped him for a three-yard loss.
Chase Rose.
Alexander gets the hand up, gets outside, and into the end zone, touchdown. I'm Alexander.
Touchdown, Tigers, 5-yard touchdown run, number 44.
For hand off. The running back runs to the near side over the 10, 5, into the end zone, touchdown. Ethan Robinson, his second carry of the ball game, and he goes for 6 points. Well, the Tigers, they hand off to Ethan Robinson, and Robinson winds his way into the end zone for another Lewis and Clark touchdown on the ground as Robinson picks up his second touchdown of the ball game.
Nelson on the drop, the middle once again breaks free from a tackler in the backfield, sprints across the 30, breaks free down to the 20, 15, 10, touchdown, Milton Nelson, lightning in a bottle for the Lewis and Clark Tigers. He was almost down 5 yards back in the backfield, somehow broke free and took it right up the gut for six.
Going to the house every time, baby, to the house.
And Bemis will hand it off to Robinson. Big running room around the right side. Breaks for it to 45, all the way down to the 30. Trips up to the 25. Still manages to go all the way down to the 23-yard line.
Good.
Hash mark, he's going to hand it off to Chase Rhodes around the left side. Excellent. Milton Nelson breaks across the 45, 46, the tackle, back across the grade, the 45, 46, 10, touchdown, Milton Nelson, 47 yards for Peter, and Milton Nelson puts the Lewis and Clark Tigers up only 19 seconds into the ball game. In the East Valley territory, across the 45, pushed out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Milton Nelson, top running right there, refusing to go down. Underneath center will hand it off to Nelson here to the left side, cuts it back up the hash mark, across the 40, goes by the defender, and is brought down by a shoot top at the 15-yard line. Milton Nelson with the quick burst up the middle for 25 yards. Hand off to Robinson over the way. Goes to the inside, bounces it to the outside, shields the stiff arm, scurries up across the 25-yard line, across the 20, pushed out of bounds, and Ethan Robinson with some good runs there.
First and 10 to the 25, out around the left corner, down in here on the 10, the 5 still driving into the end zone, looking to shy on the 1-yard, Milton Nelson. Holy cow.
As I said, Dave, he's only 5'7", 160 pounds, but he just ran over a defender, made contact at the 7-yard line right there, drug him all the way in, and it pretty much looked like he got into the end zone on that one right there. They're calling him just a hair short on.
Delta, the defense, takes the step, out to the outside, good yard here, on top the 25 to 30, still good, get across the 20, 25, left hand to Dean, he's inside, good by Garrett, still on his feet, he will cover!
Milton Nelson, the senior, takes it around the left side, goes 80 yards, and he does a great job of keeping his feet while getting hit a couple times on that run. The last one coming down at about the 15-yard line, if it gets in for six, and we're going to have ourselves a great ball.
Inside the 30, inside the 25, down to the 23-yard line, Hines Alexander.
This time, LC runs it. Hines Alexander with plenty of running room outside. Got some good blocks downfield for the receivers as well.
Sure thing to here. Handoff to Milton Nelson. Breaks one tackle the line of scrimmage on his feet out across the 40. Cuts back inside 45. Out near midfield. What a tremendous effort by Milton Nelson. Three cutbacks and he gets out to midfield.
That was just nasty right there by Milton Nelson. He put on the brakes, watched the defender fly by, and now he's had a lot of trouble with his left leg. He's got a crank in there, he's got a workout, but he just shook him. Milton Nelson put on the brakes, watched his fly by, and then continued for a couple extra yards.
Motion to the backfield from right to left. Handoff to the back, Chase Rhodes running through.
He went for Alex Weber, and he made sure that Alex Weber was not going to have a chance to get to that football.
The point after sending the kick on the way by C.J. Moe is on the way, and it's putting the upright. It's 52-21, an offensive explosion from the Lewis Clark Tigers.
Right to left. He's going to go from right to left, avoid left.
I know.
CJ Moore just one more.
deep shot down the left side. It'll be taken at the 10-yard line. Across the 15, breaks it up across the right half, across the 35-40. 1 minute to beat. It's the kicker, and he brings him down at the 50-yard line, breaking free for the world before Tiger. There's Cameron Harkey down the right half, but making the touchdown. Snap is down low with the kick. Beautiful kick, lifting upright, no doubt about that one. T.J. Moe puts it through, and it's 24-3. And the ensuing kickoff is up at the body. He's Sally Knight. Willis, the Clark defender, there in time, but weren't able to scoop it up. Wants to see scrum for the football at the 24-yard line. No signal yet. And the officials trying to unpile bodies from over there. And L.C. players jumping up in excitement. Wants to see L.C. get the football.
Line of scrimmage at 38-yard line. The snap is over the head of Andy Larkin. The punter is back around the 10-yard line. Somehow gets his foot into it and just belts it. And now the ball's on the turf, picked up by an LC Tiger. This is Milton Nelson. He's to the 40, to the 30. Cuts back inside of the 24-yard line.
That play was absolutely ridiculous, what happened right there. They snap it over the head of Andy Largent. He somehow picks up the ball. It gets off about a 45-yard punt. And then the returner for the Lewis-Aquinas Tigers has it bounced off.